Hi, Blue Emu. I'm Heidi Watney. JT Realmuto reminded Mets fans why they wanted him so badly this offseason as he helped propel the Phils to a win over their division rival. And we're still talking about Akil Baddoo as he continues to impress in his first week in the bigs, add an RBI triple to his resume, and he was showing off his arm in the outfield as well. Plus, Nick Castellanos hit another home run on Wednesday, and he wasn't the only one as the Reds continued to show off their high-powered offense. But first, well, no one said snapping a 12-game losing streak in the Bronx would be easy, right? But that is exactly what the Orioles did following that game-ending double play. In fact, the win is only Baltimore's fourth in their last 29 games played at Yankee Stadium. And yet the Brewers get out of town with the rubber game victory in extras. And while that's bad news for the Cubs, what's worse is that they're likely to face Brandon Woodruff once again next week when these teams meet in Milwaukee. Now off to Philly. Time now for some QP trivia. The Padres entered play on Wednesday with the best ERA in the National League. The last time the Friars led the NL in ERA was 2007. So which San Diego pitcher won the Cy Young that year? Think about it. We'll have the answer for you after the break. It is entertaining. Now, before the break, we asked you which Padres pitcher won the NL Cy Young Award in 2007, and that would be none other than Jake Peavy, who finished his campaign with a 2.54 ERA and a career-high 240 strikeouts. Speaking of Cy Young winners, Blake Snell towed the rubber for the Padres against the Giants on Wednesday. List through the season's first 6 days, the Braves get on the board by picking up two on Wednesday. And hats off to not only the Braves' bullpen, but also to the Panda, Pablo Sandoval, who now already has a pair of pinch-hit homers on the season. Meanwhile, Steven Strasburg was sharp in his 2021 debut, allowing just one hit over six scoreless in Game 2. Garrett has proclaimed the Reds the cockiest team ever, and at this point, can you blame them? Their 57 runs through six games are the most of any team this century and the most in 132 total seasons of franchise history. That's right. Not even their big red machine teams in the 70s scored as many. Next up, Blue Jays and Rangers. Bieber is on the mound, and Jose Ramirez is doing his thing at the plate. This Indians team is really tough to beat. Ramirez now has the second most multi-homer games in the majors over the last four seasons, despite ranking outside the top 15 in total home runs in that same span. They like to save the best for last in Oakland as the Athletics walked it off on Wednesday to get their first win of the season against Trevor Bauer and the Dodgers. Now, dating back to the start of 2018, no team has more walk-offs than the A's, who've completed the feat 27 times. Now let's head to the Fens for Red. The Mariners were 12 outs away from being swept, but said not so fast by matching the highest scoring inning for any team in the majors this season with seven runs in the bottom of the sixth. Now to South Florida, where the Cards off and now for last call and in honor of three great baseball movies all opening on April 7th, The Bad News Bears, Major League, and The Sandlot. We want to know which one is your favorite. So, of course, we took the question to Twitter, and it looks like Major League is your winner with nearly 50% of the vote. Just a bit outside. I think I'm going to have to agree with that one. Thanks so much for joining us here on Quick Pitch. I'm Heidi Watney. Have a good one.